We must therefore hand over our proceedings to the Most High, Chukwuke Kabiama Purumihanina, and in so doing, invite the Spirit of Heaven to take charge of what we are doing here today, because it is pivotal. And we must pray in the language of heaven, of course. Chineke na nke pụrụ ime ihe niile. Chukwu okike abịa ma bụ onye mmụọ na mmadụ na-efe.
Thank you so much for joining me on my program once again. I appreciate you wherever you are connecting from. If you are joining me from Africa, from Asia, from Europe, from America, from Australia, I thank you very much for your contributions on the channel. Thank you for your comments on the comment section at all time. I really do appreciate you. Please continue to comment on the comment section each time you watch my video. Make sure you share it with other people. Share it with your friends. Share it in every platform where you belong. Let people hear our story. We cannot allow them to be telling our stories their own way. No, we will not allow them. This is more reason why you have to use every platform that you have to speak up about the situation of that red contraption called Nigeria, which is not favorable to anybody. The contraption is not favorable to anybody. It doesn't matter where you come from. You might be from the north, from the south, east, from the southwest, wherever you are from. That very contraption, whatever be your religion, is not doing you any good. It's not favorable to anybody. That is why we have to speak up. Let the world know the true situation of that contraption so that they can come to our aid. Let us have our referendum so that people can choose their faith, choose where they want to belong, and practice what they want to practice peacefully without anybody coming to interrupt them, without anybody killing them for their faith, without anybody forcing them to take their land from them by all means. That is why we have to speak up. Let us speak up. We are not asking for war. We are not hating anybody. We are not talking down on anybody. All we are asking is that let live. Live and let's live. Let everybody have the right to exist. Human right for everybody to exist. Right for everybody to defend themselves. That is what we are asking for. Self-defense is the right for everybody. As the contraption Nigeria is now consuming everybody. Don't be silent. Don't fold your hands. Don't fold your hands and keep quiet. Even if you are not on the ground to fight. Your voice can fight a whole lot. Your voice can fight for your people back home. Your voice can fight for your people back home. That's why you have to speak up. You never know who is going to come across your video. You never know. That is why each time anybody watch, share with your friends. Share to any platform where you belong. You never know who is going to come across the video to know what is happening in Nigeria. It is not well. A lot of people are losing their life on a daily basis. The contraption called Nigeria is taking the life of the citizens instead of protecting them. The insecurity has become unmanageable. It cannot be managed anymore. The insecurity cannot be managed anymore. They have been pretending for a very long time, but this time around they can no longer pretend. It is very clear and glaring at everywhere that the whole place is being insecure. The north have been taken over. The north is much more worse than Somalia as we speak now, and they are transferring the insecurity to the southern part of Nigeria by all means possible. Who are those transferring that insecurity? The government of Nigeria, the military controlled by Muhammadu Buhari, are causing insecurity in this southern part of Nigeria as we speak. Remember, they recruited Boko Haram into their military, telling us that they are repentant Boko Haram. After recruiting them, they take them to the field, and all they do is they kill their opponent who is fighting against Boko Haram. They have exported them into the southern part of Nigeria, and a lot of people are losing their life on a daily basis. You can see what they are doing at where, at Imo State. They go to people's house, they burn their house and claim that these people are the unknown gunmen. They burn their houses and make sure they kill people who are there. This has been happening time without number, unabated. Nobody been held accountable. Just for the fact that somebody called himself a member of IPOB, he faces a death penalty. They shoot him at the site. Even a police chief, IG, came out to ask people to shoot on site. Give a shoot on site order in Imo State. Who are they shooting on site? Innocent citizens. They say they are attacking ESN, they are attacking IPOB. If you are attacking ESN, go to the bushes. That is where ESN are doing our operation. Martin Nadekan has said this time without number that ESN are working in the bushes. Go to the bush and face them if you want to face ESN. You say you are facing the IPOB. Everybody from the old Southeastern region is a member of IPOB. So whenever you say you are fighting against IPOB, you are declaring war against the whole Southeastern region. That is what you are doing. It's a shame that the leaders in the Southeastern region, those who call themselves elite, the Ohanesendibo and the Pandef and whatever they call themselves, they forget to recognize this, that when a war is being declared against IPOB, it's a war against the southern region, old southeastern region. They refuse to address this, and it's happening every time again. Government of Nigeria is a government that kills its own people. It never protects its own people. It never fights for the favor of its people. You can see from history, from the time onset, the government of Nigeria has been killing, and they never apologize for their killing. They killed the Biafrans time without number, take a lot of life, more than 5 million people died. They never apologize. They never make correction, and they never stop. They are still killing. So many prominent men were killed without any apology. Delegiwa was killed. They never held anybody accountable for the death of Delegiwa. They never investigated and found out who killed Delegiwa. Even though we know who killed him, they never brought anybody to book. Fela's mother was killed. Fela's mother was killed and the family property burnt and destroyed. Nobody has been held accountable. They tell this on no soldier. Up to date, nobody has been held accountable. Nobody apologized. Up to date. Bola Ige was killed. Nobody apologized. Up to date. Kudirat was killed. Nobody apologized. Up to date. So many other prominent people. Ken Saro-Wiwa was killed. Nobody apologized. Up to date. Adaka Obodo was killed. Nobody apologized. Up to date. A lot of prominent people who are fighting a legitimate fight has been killed in that very contraption without any apology. We just saw that of June 12 that happened recently when Muhammad Buhari said he came to apologize for the killing of Moshood Abiola during the June 12. That wasn't an apology. He did that to score a political point. It wasn't any apology. It wasn't an apology because you cannot be apologizing for the death of somebody and then you are promoting and exalting the person that caused that death. You build a stadium in the name of Abacha, a dictator that killed an innocent man. You celebrate him in the north and you say you're apologizing. That is no apology. If you want to apologize, we don't have to have anything that has to do with Abacha in that very contraption called Nigeria. If truly you wanted to apologize, you remove his name from the national stadium. How can you name a national stadium on the name of that a person that committed murder, killed an innocent man? This is the kind of country we have as Nigeria. They kill innocent people without pity. Anytime you see them showing pity to anybody or pretending to apologize, they never apologize for your own good. It wasn't a genuine apology. They are only doing it to score a point. They are only doing it to spoil a court, to convince you and confuse you so that you will not know how to go through it. I would like you to hear from somebody from that very contraption called Nigeria, the son to Fela, what he had to say about the atrocities of Nigerian government on its people. Let us watch.
Who voted for Obasanjo in 1999? Then there was no social media, or it was just starting, if I'm very sure, but I can't remember Facebook or anything was existed. So it was the media, international media, and everybody say Obasanjo is the best person to rule this country. A soldier who is British trained. Do you understand what I'm saying? He's British trained, he's a soldier. Why don't they tell the soldier to take over Britain? Why did they tell the soldier to take over France or America? Remember Colin Powell, after he came from the Iraq war, when some people were agitating for him to go and become president of America, he quickly said, no, I'm a soldier. He's a soldier. He's not trained to lead. He's not trained to govern. He's trained to lead war and defend the country. That is his training. Obasanjo's just training. In the school he went to is not to lead. He can never be a leader of a nation. He's trained to be a warrior, to defend that nation. That is why you have intellectuals. The school of thought is the intellectuals, the people behind the brain, the physicians, the chemistry, mathematicians, they will sit down. The people we elect, are they the best brains? What makes them, what makes you think that you, a soldier, have more integrity than the PhD holder? Do you understand what I'm saying? But do we blame them? So somebody like now say, why did they push this man again on us after what he did that Fela even sang about? Did Fela's children support that? I was very much in that time and my song, Sorry Sorry, was pushed down the drain. I went to Big Brother then. They abused the hell out of me. I can never forget all those days. Then suddenly, Fela is the most important figure now. Everything Fela, 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 Fela. Then they use Fela against Buhari. They forget they have already voted Fela's worst enemy. Then they don't want to talk about it because they already, and my song Shoton brings us to there that I told you before, this path we have taken, we are going to enter hell. And it's the same path we have taken. because they voted for Obasanjo, they voted for Yar'Adua. Then when you are talking of Jonathan, was Jonathan not wanted by the EFCC? How did they put that case quickly under the table? Have you all forgotten that? Oh, they put that case under the table. Then suddenly, because Obasanjo sanctioned him to be vice president, the case died down. As the case of Yabo, his own daughter, that when Obasanjo put EFCC, we heard nothing again about the case. And everyone said, EFCC is going to arrest his daughter. What happened to her? Nothing. So Jonathan now became president. And then they voted Buhari. And then his fellow children again that has to be blamed for their own actions. So I'm just trying to let you see the gravity of our thoughts, that the way we are forced to think. If we are thinking as Africans, this is not how we will think. First of all, nobody will have voted. Obasanjo will have been like a power that will say, excuse me, nation, my training is to defend the nation. I'm not trained to govern you. He will have resigned that path immediately. But because he's as corrupt in that thought as everybody wanted to rule, he took it. Apparently, again, he wanted to even seek third term. Apart from what we are reading. So there are so many things we can keep on questioning, and I can go on and on. But you see, you're making me rush now. You can hear my horn players. But I'm trying to summarize all these things quickly for you. If you had come on time, we would have sat down, and this discussion will take nothing less than 2 hours. You see, I don't talk again. Oshibajo, vice president, comes to meet me. Then automatically they say, I'm supporting him. And I've said it many times in public, even to his own belly. I've never supported you, but I only answered you because you came directly to... I didn't go to his house, so he came to my house. So because he came to my house, I'm supporting Buhari. And when he came to my house, I told you, excuse me, sir, this man jailed my father. There is nothing again I want to hear. My father is dead. But this man jailed my father. So, if you tell me he's a man of integrity, I didn't see the integrity when he jailed my father. Now my father is dead. I cannot be seen to be part of... It's not. Is it only about Fela? The burning of the house, Nko, which federal government has apologized for that. The killing of... Let's even forget that, if we can. The killing of Fela's mother. This Kuti family has suffered year in, year out of this government. She died from injuries that she sustained. Everybody knows this story. Have they apologized? Have they accepted the blame? But then, they keep blaming us.
Well, after hearing from him, I cannot say it better than he had just said. The contraption called Nigeria cannot work, even though people continue to pretend. Continue to pretend and talk about diversity. That issue of diversity is what gets me upset every time. The diversity in Nigeria is what is causing problems. We don't have the same ideology. We are not the same people. The north and the southern part of Nigeria are not the same people. They do not have the same mentality. It doesn't matter how educated they are. It doesn't matter their religion. It doesn't matter where they belong. It doesn't matter where they've been trained. The ideology of the north and that of the south are not the same. And these two ideologies will always clash at all. It will always clash to take lives. Why are we still pretending? Why don't we call it off? Call it off and let people grow at their own speed. Let people have a legitimate place they can be able to defend and be patriotic to. How can somebody be patriotic to a country that kills him? Nigeria doesn't mean any good for any of his citizens. They never celebrate anybody who is working hard. Instead of celebrating, they celebrate monsters, celebrate fraudsters. The celebration of fraudsters and celebration of wicked people has even impacted the citizens of that very country called Nigeria. All the indigenous people have been infected with this kind of attitude. Sometimes you see some people, they celebrate people who are rich, not minding how they make their money. They don't care how you make your money. So long you have money, you see people in your area begin to celebrate you. People you don't know begin to celebrate you simply because you are rich, simply because you bought a new car, simply because you're living large. You see people begin to celebrate you, not minding how you make your money, how you get it. This is the kind of mentality that contraption called Nigeria have impacted into the mindset of the people living in that very contraption. That is why you have to end it. If you don't end it now, it is going to be much more deadly than you can imagine. This is the time to end it. Break it up so that the people can go and build a new nation from grassroots. Sanitize themselves and build a new nation. Biafra is going home already. They are already gone. And Biafra is sanitizing from the grassroots for people to be able to live like human again in Biafra land. People could be able to live like human again, live with integrity. That is what we're asking for. So that every region, every indigenous people in that way contraption will go and build themselves from foundation. Have a strong foundation, a foundation that can make them proud and make them produce responsible and reasonable human beings. As Nigeria is structured now, you cannot get anything out of Nigeria except death, destruction. That is the only thing that comes out of Nigeria. That is why we are calling for a breakup. Whatever platform you have, speak up. Don't sit on the fence. Speak up. If you're a Biafran, speak for Biafran. If you're a Yoruba, speak for Oduduwa. If you're for the Middle West, speak with the Middle Westerns. We are not asking for war. We are not asking for the damage of anybody. We are asking for peace. That everybody will have the right to grow. Everybody should have the right to grow at their own speed and be able to achieve whatever they want to achieve on their own session. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for watching wherever you are watching from. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please kindly subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell so that you'll be notified each time I upload a video. Thank you and remember this. God bless Mazen Nandekan. God bless Sonibu. God bless Biafra. God bless Oduduwa. God bless the Middle Belter. God bless Arewa also. Let them wake up and continue to fight on their own direction. Thank you and remember this. Bye-bye. See you again on the next video. Thank you.